Good morning, my name is Juan Carlos Cortés and I'm going to present the talk entitled Some Tools to Study Random Fractional Differential Equations and Applications. This work has been done in collaboration with my colleagues Clara Burgos, María Dolores Rosselló and Rafael Villanueva. All of us belong to the Instituto Universitario de Matemática Multidisciplinar at the Universidad Politécnica de Valencia in Spain. Random fractional differential equations are useful mathematical tools to model problems involving memory effects and uncertainties. To motivate the use of fractional differential equations, I have chosen the classical Newton's law of cooling given by the following linear ordinary differential equation and having the following explicit solution. In the recent literature, some authors have proposed to interchange the classical derivative by the following fractional derivative, defined in terms of the following non-local operator and being phi an increasing function and alpha the order of fractional differentiation. The solution of this equation is explicitly given by the following expression in terms of the Mittal-Leffler function. In this reference, the author shows that for real data, the fractional model that takes as the phi function the identity, so the fractional derivatives become the so-called Caputo fractional derivative, reduces significantly the error of the fitting. And the value of the order of differentiation in the fractional case differs quite from the classical one. This shows that the fractional derivative can provide a better fitting and even physical explanation of certain phenomena. But apart from the improving the model in this direction, we must stress that the cooling coefficient represented by the parameter k is obtained in practice after experimental measurements, involving errors, and also it has certain knowledge because the heterogeneity of the medium. So it is more natural to consider it, to consider that this parameter is a random variable rather than a deterministic constant. So joining both ideas, the use of fractional derivative together with the consideration of randomness in the model formulation leads to the field of random fractional differential equations. For this kind of equation, the main goal is not only to calculate the solution, which is a stochastic process, but also its main characteristic functions, like the mean and the variance. To this end, in this work, we will work in the random setting of the given by the L2 Hilbert space of second order random variables, that is, random variables having finite variance, and provided by the following norm that defines the mean square convergence. This stochastic convergence has a key property to very well connected to our main goal, and is the following. If we are able to construct a sequence of approximation of the solutions that are mean square convergent to the limit representing the solution, then the expectation and the variance of the approximations will converge to the respective values of the solution of the limit. But apart from the computation of the mean and the variance, it is more desirable to calculate the first probability density function. Why? Because by integrating this deterministic function, we can obtain not only the mean and the variance, but also any higher one-dimensional moment. And apart from that, we can obtain, again, by its integration, the probability that the solution lies in a specific interval of interest, as well as to construct accurate, credible intervals. Now I pass to present the analysis of the following autonomous random fractional differential equation that extends the previous Newton's cooling model. Here, the derivative is considered in the Caputo sense and is defined in the stochastic setting by the following mean square integral. We will assume that all the input model parameters, the initial condition beta zero, the force inter gamma, and the diffusion coefficient lambda are mutually independent random variables living in the L2 space. Additionally, we will assume to conduct our study that the growth of the moments of the diffusion coefficient lambda are bounded by the following function. At this point, it's very important to stress that there are important families of the probabilistic distribution satisfying this second hypothesis. For instance, every bounded random variable satisfies condition H2, taking P equal to 0, H equal to 1, and eta equal to 1, and we also find other unbounded random variables like the Gaussian, exponential, and Abelian satisfying that condition. Well, the first step is to construct the solution by means of a generalized random power series. And we prove that depending on the relationship between the parameter P appearing in the hypothesis H2 and the value of the alpha of the fractional differentiation order, this random generalized power series converges in the mean squared sense for any positive value of T, or when both values match in the following bounded interval. Apart from studying the mean squared convergence, now we compute the main statistical properties of the solutions. At this point, it's very important to underline that we take advantage of the key property of the mean squared convergence. So we first truncate the solution and up to a certain level, capital M, and we calculate the approximation of the mean and the approximation of the variance. It is important to point out that these explicit expressions are given in terms of the moments of the input of random variables. Well, here I show you a first example where the initial condition is an exponential random variable with mean the unit. The force inter gamma is a normal distribution with mean 0 and standard deviation 0.05, and the diffusion coefficient is a bounded random variable, specifically following a beta distribution, so fulfills hypothesis H2 for P equal to 0, and we take as a fractional order of differentiation alpha equal to 0.3. This means that the value of P is smaller than the order of fractional differentiation, and we can observe in the plots for both the mean and the standard deviation that we have a convergence for any value greater than 0, for any value of T greater than 0. We observe that as the value of the truncation order increases, the approximations improve. Each one is closer to the other, having the value of the truncation order M greater. But remember that apart from the computation of the expectation and the variance, we are also interested in computing approximation of the probability density function of the solution. To this goal, we use the following result called, in the literature, random variable transformation technique that mainly tell us how to calculate the probability density function of a vector y, which result of mapping another vector, random vector x, whose probability density function is now. Observe that the expression is given in terms of the PDF of the random vector x, as well as the Jacobian of the mapping of the transformation. In our case, we take to define this mapping R the following components. The first one is the a linear combination of the two truncated series defining the solution, and for the two last components, the diffusion coefficient and the force integral. So applying this result and after some technical computations, we can check that the first PDF of the the approximation of order m of the solution of the fractional differential equation is given by the following double integral, which depend of the PDF of the three random inputs beta zero, gamma, and lambda. And under the previous conditions, we show that this expression converges to the one PDF of the solution of the random fractional differential equations as the order of truncation capital N goes to infinity. Now I show you to complete example the computation of the PDF assuming the same data for different values of t, 1, 5, and 10. And we observe graphically that as the value of the order of truncation capital M increases, the approximations of the PDF are close. So evidencing the convergence. But now we study extent of analysis for non-autonomous random fractional initial value problem. We specifically study this problem that generalize the well now Irish ordinary differential equation where the order of differentiation is alpha equal to 2 and the beta parameter is the unit. Following a similar analysis on the as in the previous case, we construct the solution and we prove its convergence, mean square convergence, depending on the value of the parameters p and alpha, and we also construct approximations for both the mean and the variance using the linearity properties of the expectation operator and the bilinearity of the covariance operator. As a main difference with respect to the previous problem, the approximation of the PDF is done by taking advantage of the maximum entropy principle. Since we have we know the approximation for both the mean and the variance. So according to this principle, the PDF is seek in the following exponential form, and the coefficient lambda 0, lambda 1, and lambda 2 are computing by solving this nonlinear system. To illustrate this procedure, we have computed for the following data. Observe that we don't need to give explicit distribution for the parameters in the initial condition, but only its first moments. We have calculated the approximation for the mean and the variance. Observe that as the order of truncation of the random power solution increases, the approximations improve and the mean oscillate tending to zero, while the variance also oscillates and it's going to zero. This graphical behavior can also be observed in the computation of the 1PD via the entropy method, where we can see in this 3D representation as the value of the mean oscillates and the PDF becomes leptocurtic as t goes to zero, since the variance reduces over the time. Just to conclude, I want to summarize the main contribution of this paper. First, we have presented an extension of some classical analytic and numerical method to deal with uncertainties in the setting of fractional differential equations. The methods are capable to calculate reliable approximation not only of the mean and the variance, but also to go further by computing the PDF of the solution. And we think that our approach can be applied to extend the classical theory for deterministic fractional differential equations containing randomness in its formulation. That's all from my side. Thank you very much.